Hello, everyone. I'm Zoe. And my topic is improved description of global mixed layer depth using Argo profiling float. Sorry, I need you. Okay, what's a mixed layer? Please look at these figures. The wind force will drive a mixing process in the upper ocean and create a vertical homogeneous layer, which means in this in a vertical direction of the layer, the temperature and the salinity are similar. And MLDs mean mixed layer depth. So why we care about a mixed layer? It's because there are so many marine process and phenomena that happens in the tiny layer, such as water mass formation, freshwater and air exchange, phytoplankton activities, and something related to the climate change. In the past, if we want to analyze the global mixing layer depth, we can only use a small number of data, and the distributions are usually uneven, and we can only analyze it with a monthly variability. And then second, the data, because it's collected by different sampling tools, so the quality and the resolution are different, so it's hard to combine and analyze with each other. And this is why we are doing this research, and we use Argo float data. The Argo project was started in 2000, and from now it's over 300 floats covered the sea and produce over 100,000 units of the data per year. This is a picture of the Argo floats. Let's see the distribution of the data in World Ocean Database in 2005, including the CDD data and the ocean station data. You can see this black area means in that grid have the data. And this is the data collected by Argo floats in 2007. There is also another figure for the distribution of the data. The x-axis is time, and the y-axis is the radius of the grid that's covered by the data. And this different type of line indicate a different ocean. For example, if there are totally 100 grid in Pacific, and we have 30 grid that have a data of the Argo, the radius will be 0.3. That's the radius mean. These four lines for the Argo. And this red line is data in World Ocean Database, which only 0.05 in 2008. So combine the two figures, we make a conclusion that the data collected by Argo floats are more complete and filled almost every region of the oceans. The objective of this research is that we believe we can use Argo data to help to construct and describe the global mixing layer depth in the high temporal and the spatial resolutions. And therefore, we need to first make a map, global mixing layer map, and we are also comparing the data with the station data in order to show the advantage of the Argo float. And next is the data and the method. First, we need to do the quality control for the Argo data. And most importantly is that we need to make sure both the data have both temperature and salinity value, because we need to use this value to calculate the mixing layer depth. And after doing the quality control, we can make this figure. The x-axis is as usual the time, and the y-axis in the left-hand side is the number of profiles, and in the right-hand side is the rate. The gray area is mean the number of old profiles, and black is mean the bad one. Okay, let us focus on the rate of the bad profile. As you can see, the rate decreased dramatically from 57% in 2001 to less than 10% in 2008. So since 2004 is here, the rate of bad data decreased and stabilized. Let's have a close look to the bad data in 2001. You can see there's the data Y can't be used in the research. Mostly it's because there are no salinity sensor. It's 82%. But in 2008, not only the rate of the bad profile decreased, but also the no salinity sensor decreased from 80% to 2%. The conclusion is that most recent Argo profile include temperature and salinity data. And next is station data. We use two stations. First is station Papa, which is located in the high latitude, and the station Triton, located in the low latitude. And the last is we use the potential density threshold difference method to define the mixing layer depth. The method is that we take a specific depth of the potential density and compare it to the 10 decibar data. And if the difference is larger than 0.03 kg per volume, we'll define that depth as mixing layer depth. Okay, let's move on to the result part. The first is a global mixing layer map. This two map is constructed by the Argo float data in March and October in 2008. It's a time. And the color bar is mean the depth, and the red is mean deeper, and blue is the shallower. You can see some seasonal variation in this figure in the high latitude area, which means the mixing layer will increase in the winters and will reach the maximum value also in the winter. And we can also find some regional differences in this map. It's all for the October. We can see there's a deeper area in the subtropic and also in the eastern of the ocean. The next conclusion is with comparison with station data. This is the data Papa, and we can see there is a clear seasonal variation. The maximum, the mixing layer will shallows in the summer and will increase in the falls and reach a peak in the winters and decrease in the spring. There's a clear variation. If we compare the station data with Argo, we can observe that the biggest difference happens in the in the spring. In the Argo data, there has big fluctuations from 20 decibar to 150 decibar. And this cannot be seen in the station Papa data. And the next station is the Triton. Because this station is located in the low latitude area, so the seasonal variation is not as obvious as station Papa, but you can still see the same trend. Also, you can see a clear pinocchio through the density. And we compare the Triton with Argo. We can see both the same features that the Argo have a big variation in the winters and spring, but not shown in the Triton data. In conclusion, Argo 10 days data are better in describe and the subseasonal variations, because there you can see there's a big variations. So let me briefly summarize the results. First, the Argo project data have fills most of regions globally with high quality and both temperature and salinity data. So the global graded mixing layer map can be improved by Argo project data. The next is Argo 10 days data has good vertical resolution and coupled with the subseasonal detail. So the Argo 10 days observation are better in demonstrating subseasonal and vertical variation of mixing layer depth. Okay, thank you for listening.
So I think you did a great job, and it's my little suggestion that you the page you talk about the location, two location. Yes, and I think it will be better to put the relative location instead of the latitude, so we can be more convenient to compare the location.
Related location. Okay.
Yes.
And my suggestion is that I can put the related location instead of the longitude and latitude, like maybe the high latitude and the low latitude area. Is that what you mean?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. I would definitely do that.
I want to know how Argo functions.
That's a great question. Toby wants to know how the Argo functions, but I don't quite understand because it's not mentioned in this paper. I believe it will dive into the deeper ocean and will dive up to collect data, like CDD. It's a small CDD. I think we can Google it.
Hi, I have a question in your slide 7. Can you explain y-axis again? I didn't hear clearly.
Y-axis. It's a radius of the grid that's covered by the data. For example, if there have 100 data in Pacific, and there's 30 grid covered by data, the radius will be 30 divided 100, will be 0.3. Yeah, is that clear? 0.4 is like 40 grid in 100 grid covered by data.
I think you can give more explanation for the graph because it is complicated for me to understand it.
Maybe I can make more explanation of these figures. I'm not sure I can make a small illustration or something, maybe. I will do that next time.
Okay.
Sorry, can you move to the slide where the error occurs, like which when the data can
this.
Be used. Yes.
This.
Yes. And the next, yes. I was curious about how to define a data as a good data or bad data.
Sorry.
Since there's good profile or bad profile.
We have the quality control. Means that we set a different standard for the different data. It's like we set a range of the pressure and temperature and salinity, and we ask the data have both temperature and salinity data. So after doing this standard, this quality control, we can make sure all of the data will have a qualify of this.
Thanks.
I think Zoe, she also gave a very nice talk, considering that it's a physical oceanography paper, which is usually more complicated, difficult for the class. I think she did a good job. And of course, she presented the topic selectively, so she didn't present all of them. Otherwise, your brain will be... Okay, so let's now review her slides. So first of all, it's really great that this one is really important. That is why your topic is important. Okay, so if I have comment for your introduction section, that always often means you probably need to emphasize the importance of your topic. So like this one, because this is probably not necessarily described in the paper that you chose, but you need to figure out why this worth your presentation, so why it is important. So this is a good example. And then the explanation of mixed layer is also nice. And then considering this graph, I agree that because you even take out the axis, so that really depends on your oral description. And then because you are talking about grids, something, I agree that next time it will be good for you to make a small cartoon or something to explain it. If you think this is an important message to convey, then spend a little bit more time on that. And then and you can also see that she always conclude her data, although so far this is introduction. She always conclude her data like this one or this one or many others, where she show what's the key message. So this is super important. You give us a closure, okay? So what is important here? So this is nice. And then do not copy and paste table from this. Okay, and then here you have definition of MLD again. I am actually not really sure how far you are with this. I suppose that you are from this department, you should all know this. And I think a better way for you to improve next time is again to use illustration to help us to better understand this. Right. And then, and what do you mean by this? Okay, so it would be good to use illustration. And then, I think here you are a bit fast because you did not even explain the background image here. What's the number here? You go very quickly to say something like, the trend was like this and that. And so it would be great. And the different color of MLD you did not explain. So if you think, because you don't show too many data. So here, I think you can take time, explain them well. And because you have the same color coding for other figures, so that can be used further. Okay. Take time to explain it. And then, I think the conclusion was also really nice. So this is a clear, straightforward image, not image, it's a message to tell you the main finding of this paper. So I think as a physical oceanography presentation, this one is really great. So let's thank Zoe.